Ballad Number 41 of the Bab Ballads by W. S. Gilbert, read for LibriVox.org by Graham Redman. The Three Kings of Chickeraboo. There were three niggers of Chickeraboo, Pacifico, Bang Bang, Pop Chop, who exclaimed one terribly sultry day, "Oh, let's be kings, in a humble way." The first was a highly accomplished Bones, the next elicited banjo tones, the third was a quiet retiring chap who danced an excellent breakdown flap. "We niggers," said they, "have formed a plan by which, whenever we like, we can extemporize kingdoms near the beach, and then we'll collar a kingdom each. Three casks from somebody else's stores shall represent our island shores. Their sides the ocean wide shall lave, their heads just topping the briny wave. Great Britain's navy scours the sea, and everywhere her ships they be. She'll recognize our rank, perhaps, when she discovers we're royal chaps. If to her skirts you want to cling, it's quite sufficient that you're a king. She does not push inquiry far to learn what sort of king you are. A ship of several thousand tons, and mounting 70-something guns, ploughed every year the ocean blue, discovering kings and countries new. The brave Rear Admiral Bailey Pip, commanding that magnificent ship, perceived one day his glasses through the kings that came from Chickeraboo. 'Dear eyes,' said Admiral Pip, 'I see three flourishing islands on our lee, and, bless me, most remarkable thing, on every island stands a king!' 'Come, lower the Admiral's gig,' he cried, 'and over the dancing waves I'll glide, that low obeisance I may do to those three kings of Chickeraboo.' The Admiral pulled to the islands three, the kings saluted him graciously. The Admiral, pleased at his welcome warm, unrolled a printed alliance form. 'Your Majesty, sign me this, I pray. I come in a friendly kind of way. I come, if you please, with the best intents, and Queen Victoria's compliments.' The kings were pleased as they well could be. The most retiring of the three in a cellar flap to his joy gave vent, with a banjo Bones accompaniment. The great Rear Admiral Bailey Pip embarked on board his jolly big ship. Blue Peter flew from his lofty fore, and off he sailed to his native shore. Admiral Pip directly went to the Lord at the head of the government, who made him by a stroke of a quill Baron de Pip of Piptonville. The College of Heralds permission yield that he should quarter upon his shield three islands vert on a field of blue, with the pregnant motto Chickeraboo. Ambassadors, yes, and attachés too, are going to sail for Chickeraboo, and see, on the good ship's crowded deck, a bishop who's going out there on spec. And let us all hope that blissful things may come of alliance with darky kings, and may we never, whatever we do, declare a war with Chickeraboo." End of Ballad Number 41, The Three Kings of Chickeraboo, from the Bab Ballads. This recording is in the public domain.